so incredibly talented.
Jackson's such a sexy guy.
I think that he's an incredible sweetheart. One of the most genuine people that I have met out here, which is very refreshing.
Is Jackson Stewart ruining your life?
He's not gonna ruin it, but he's trying.
He has beautiful eyes.
I'm a popular guy. If you don't know yet, you're gonna find out why.
Man from place with L Street late one night.
And tell us about your childhood in 5 seconds.
Get out of here. Leave me alone.
We are so excited.
We
are going to go meet Jackson Stewart.
I am so
at a signing
right
for Beyond the Gate. Top 3 sexiest men in the world. Number 3, Paul Newman. Number 2, Burt Reynolds. Number 1, Jackson Stewart.
No, that's not
of Beyond the Gate.
Jackson Stewart, Jackson Stewart, Jackson Stewart.
I agree. Yeah,
that's
you guys
more accurate.
I agree.
Which one of us is pregnant with Jackson's baby?
Who is it?
Is it me?
Which one?
Let's play a little guessing game. Whoever correctly guesses before the end of the video who's pregnant with Jackson's baby, we're going to go buy a signed copy of Beyond the Gate. So if you guess correctly, you get it.
I'm so excited. I hope I don't end up crying.
I've seen it 700 times.
To get ready for Jackson?
Ready for Jackson.
Jackson has this weird thing where, like, he'll take the pistachios but only eat the shells?
Jackson's appearance? I don't even know what to say other than it's, like, intrinsically Jackson.
Yeah, but, like, he'll just throw away the nut. And then I'm like, well, I'll eat the nut if you eat the shells. He's great. I love him. I love him. But that's what he does.
Would you ever mention Boss Baby to you?
Not in particular, although I do feel like Boss Baby does sound very familiar.
So how do you know Jackson Stewart? He's kind of obsessed with me. So he kind of stalked me and... Like, if I don't, like, go places to see him, he'll just follow me to my house, and it's just like, I might as well just get it out of the way, give him his fix, and then he'll leave me alone.
Tell us about his movie, Beyond the Gates.
It's really great. Haven't seen it, but it's really great. But if I'm in the second one, I'm sure the second one will be way better. So that's why I indulge his stalking. So hopefully he'll put me in his next movie.
Okay, so I've known Jackson for like months, years, like centuries, really. Like, I feel like we're really connected in a way that I don't know anybody else that's like us, and he doesn't seem to notice. And I come to this signing, I'd say I've been to every event he's been he's been there, and he knows my address. I'm pretty sure I've sent it to him like 14 times, and I'm just trying to get in touch with him. He's a really great guy. I really, really, really love his movie.
How did you first hear about Jackson Stewart?
I saw a photo online. And that was the moment I knew. I think he's his own unique person. I think there's nobody that's like him at all.
So Jackson Stewart and I have been really good friends for years and years and years. He's actually said that I'm a major influence of all of his work, everything he does. Pretty much an influence on his life, not just his work.
Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, one time he said, Kansas, I'd probably be dead. And I was like, I don't want to take credit for that, but I think it's true.
What did you think about the movie?
Oh, Beyond the Gates, it really blew my mind. I was just like, I saw it and I was like, oh my god, Jackson. Like, you're...
Okay, I'm going to have to cut you off.
You're a baby genius.
He's a baby boss? Jackson really reminds me of Boss Baby.
Okay, I'm gonna cut you off right there, miss. Can you elaborate on that, actually?
Jackson Stewart has a Boss Baby fleshlight. And I said, Jackson, you shouldn't tell people that. But he's like,
okay, inappropriate.
Has he ever mentioned Parker Bowling to you?
No, he has not mentioned Parker Bowling.
Bad asshole. Excuse me, can you tell us what you think about Jackson Stewart? What do you think about Jackson Stewart?
I think that he's cool. He, when we were away, he babysitted our puppy, Lucis, and also named our puppy, Lucis.
You named your puppy?
Yeah.
What kind of puppy?
I have these Shih Tzu mix.
How did you come up with the name Rufus?
Who's Rufus?
The dog name.
Oh, I can't remember. It just sounded cool.
I took the photos and I printed them out. They're in the bathroom. People come by to visit every so often, and they just like rub against them and smile and yeah.
Can I come over awesome. And use your restroom?
Completely. Oh my god, anytime. You gotta see it. Oh, I think he would love it. You know, I'm still waiting for the one with the thong and the white sash.
I love that photo of him.
Tell the story about how Jackson and I met.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this is weird, so forgive me, but enough time has passed to where I feel okay telling this story. So Jackson and I met at, I don't know, it was some kind of horror gathering or whatever. We were both, like, I was trashed drunk, and I have no idea. Like, I don't think he drinks, so, I mean, I don't know. But I was, like, wasted. And we went back to his place, and we had sex. And then the next morning, I woke up, and I was really hungover, and I was, like, I couldn't even, like, walk. You know, and I had to go to the
bathroom. Did he wear you out?
I think so, right? But I had to take a shit, right? And I was like, oh my god, what do I do? And I didn't know where his bathroom was, and it was like an emergency. So I found this McDonald's bag on the floor, and I took a shit in the McDonald's bag, right? It was not something I'm proud of. And I didn't know what to do with it, so I just kind of left it on the floor, and then I like snuck out and left.
But yeah, no, sexy. Completely.
I really consider myself as a female filmmaker, but Jackson has told me to like stop looking at it that way, and he tells me to like just consider myself as a filmmaker. And I was just like, wow, I wish I could see the world through your eyes, Jackson.
Kansas and Parker are a menace to society. Cal is great.
I will not take any orders if they're not from Jackson himself. I'm a man. I'm a man, and I deserve to be treated like one. I have rights just like you ladies.
We're really disappointed because Jackson Stewart was so mean in real life. He told me to get out.
I'm pregnant with his baby.
She looks in the mirror and stares at the wrinkles that weren't there yesterday.
He was so mean, and all the DVDs were sold out! He's so mean in real life!
Now you're making her fat, see, when she's sad, so.
Lost your virginity.
I love Mario Bobo.